We had to make tools that would allow the animation, the content teams, the audio team to give you that cinematic experience.
So there's a lot of different ways that we can do it, but the main thing is that we just make it constantly like exciting point here, area of interest there, so that players feel like they're making progress.
So we use contrasting color, which goes against the palette of the rest of the environment, just to highlight key areas of interest and gently guide players. We'll dress doorways, we'll use assets as leading lines, just to again help guide the player's eyes to their objective.
And there's also kind of cheekier ways we can do it, whereby a player can drop down into an area that they then can't get out of to go back on themselves.
As with all of our Tall Tales, players have a quest book in their inventory when they start the Tall Tale, which will always give them guidance on where they should be going and what they should be doing.
So we have 5 quest books, and well, this is essentially one book where the castaway writes down the story.
And there are also checkpoints at various points along the Tall Tale. So if you do complete part of it and then for whatever reason you want to come back to it in a later session, there's a checkpoint to allow you to pick up your adventure just where you left off.
We've been able to do it in a really authentic way, paying homage to the Pirates of the Caribbean IP, what it feels like to be a Sea of Thieves player in the really physical, playful world that we've built, and also paying homage to the Disneyland ride and park in general, which have inspired a ton of the design team, I know, and probably much wider around Rare in terms of the level design and the way you move through an environment.